groundwater is, it's used by everybody everywhere for many, many, many things.
Most people don't know where their groundwater comes, where their water supply comes from. You turn the tap on and it comes out. It's our washing, our bathing, our showering, our doing our laundry, our drinking, whatever. But we irrigate for agriculture. You know, even in the city of Madison, you might have a microbrewery, or maybe you have an industry that uses water.
We have an abundance of agriculture that can grow some really unique crops for us. That diversity makes Wisconsin agriculture much stronger, but it also means that we rely on our resources, both the soil, our nutrients, our pesticides, as well as our water quality.
In order to manage a resource well, you have to be able to look at all of the possible uses of it.
The Groundwater Coordinating Council is basically a way for state agencies or other organizations within the state of Wisconsin to kind of coordinate or talk about groundwater concerns or groundwater issues.
We have the DNR, which of course has a lot to do with groundwater, but also the Department of Health, the Department of Transportation, the university, the State Geological Survey, and others who have a stake in groundwater. And it's a really a very useful place for people to talk about what each agency is doing, and that avoids overlap, it avoids duplication of effort.
You know, someone that works at the Wisconsin Department of Natural Resources might be setting groundwater standards. Somebody from the Department of Health is investigating or studying water quality and developing health-based guidelines. Department of Safety and Professional Services, the agency in charge of regulating septic system and septic system design. And that's really the goal and the genius of the GCC, is that it recognizes that, you know, we all need to work together to protect the resource.
It's one of the major funding mechanisms we have for groundwater research here in the state.
I think that the Groundwater Coordinating Council and the law that created it is a real textbook example of what we should be trying to do and trying to get back to when you're dealing with public policy and water. That is that we purposely set up a system that said how we're going to approach these critically important subjects is going to be driven by science and by an interdisciplinary collection of scientists.
It's that collaborative effort where we may have information as regulatory agencies, but it's the educators, it's the university that really can play a really significant role in helping farmers and others understand the impacts of what they're doing and the choices that they make.
And that's why this law has been used for 35 years to address 138 compounds in a way that I think has produced some of the most scientifically defensible and important standards for protecting our groundwater quality here in Wisconsin.
If you want to think of it in economic terms, groundwater is an economic driver. We can't have a healthy economy without good water resources, but also it's an environmental need. We need to maintain Wisconsin's great environment for tourism, recreation, and business.
I think the definition of being a good steward of the land has now expanded, that being good stewards of the land also includes what's below the land, which is the groundwater.